So if we look at the parallel operating system and page fault service, the easy scenario for the parallel operating system is what I'll call as a multi-process workload. And here, what we are saying is, yes, you have threads executing on all the nodes of the multiprocessor, but these threads are completely independent of one another. Think of this as a separate process. This is an independent process. Maybe you have a web browser here, a word processor here, and so on. So they are completely independent processes. And if that is the case, if there's a page fault that is incurred on this node, simultaneously a page fault on another node, they can be handled completely independently. Why? Because the threads are independent. The page tables are distinct, and therefore, you don't have to serialize the page fault service. As I told you, the parallel operating system is going to have a page fault handler that's available in each one of these nodes. So the work can be done in parallel, so long as there is no data structure that is shared among these different units of work that the operating system has to do. And so long as the page tables are distinct, which is the case in a multi-process workload, there is no serialization, and life will be good. The hard scenario for a parallel operating system is a multi-threaded workload. Now, what we mean by a multi-threaded workload is that you have a process that has multiple threads, so there is opportunity for exploiting the concurrency that's available in the multiprocessor by scheduling these threads on the different nodes of the multiprocessor. And to make it concrete, what I'm going to show you is two nodes, N1 and N2. And let's assume that there are two cores available in each one of these nodes. In that case, what I can do is the operating system may have chosen to put T1 and T3 on node N1 and T2 and T4 on node N2. So you have a multi-threaded workload now executing on different nodes of the multiprocessor. And there is hardware concurrency because there are multiple cores available. So in principle, all of these threads can work in parallel. And if they incur a page fault, it is incumbent on the operating system to see how it can ensure that there is no serialization of the work that needs to be done to service the page faults. So if you want to naively think about what the parallel operating system would be doing in this scenario, the address space is shared, and therefore the page table is shared. And since the threads are executing on different processors, the TLBs will have shared entries in the processor TLBs because they are accessing the same address space. So that will be the scenario. Now, if you think about it, what we would want is to limit the amount of sharing in the operating system data structures when they are executing on different processors. In particular, for this particular mapping that I've shown you, that T1 and T3 are executing on N1 and T2 and T4 are executing on N2, what we would want is the operating system data structures that they have to mess with, T1 and T3 have to mess with, should be distinct from the operating system data structures that T2 and T4 may have to mess with. And that will ensure that you can have scalability.